What's Demon Dreamers? So have you ever wanted to look underwater to be a treasure hunter? Or maybe pretend to be a mermaid before? I know I've tried at least one of those things at some point in the past. If so, you probably understand that it's really hard to see underwater for a number of reasons. Either the water is soapy and it hurts your eyes, or it's too cold, or it's too murky to see anything. Humans have been trying to come up with ways of seeing underwater forever. Like last year, a guy named Merman Mike actually went to the bottom of the Sacramento River and found a $17,000 ring at the bottom. Good on Merman Mike. He went and returned it to its rightful owner, but it just goes to show that there's a lot that can be gained if we could just see underwater. Fortunately, we can. A scientist in 1845 named Sarah Mather patented the idea of an underwater telescope. Now, she did so to see the bottom of ships to make sure there were no holes or cracks at the bottom, but we use the same technology today all the time, from cheap plastic $1 goggles you can buy from the dollar store to glass bottom boats, which are available all over the panhandle. I'm going to be showing you how to make your own out of household ingredients. So if you've ever wanted to be a diver looking for hidden treasure, or a merperson from The Little Mermaid, then this is the video for you. Hang tight, we'll get into it. Let's get started. So here's what I used as far as making my own aquascope. I used a plastic bottle with the bottom cut off of it. You might want to get your parent to help you cutting it, because plastic and sharp objects is really hard to cut. Of course, scissors to do your cutting, some duct tape, and plastic saran wrap that's see-through. So I'll show you guys what I did. Step one, take your plastic saran wrap. You want to get a nice big piece of it rolled out for you. Make sure you keep it as straight as possible. You want to make sure that you can see through it. I tried doubling it over once and it was harder to see through, so you kind of want to keep a single sheet here. When you're done, you can just pull it off of its roll. You can also use scissors for this. And once you have your singular plastic piece, you want to grab the bottle or tube that you prepared earlier. Make sure it's a waterproof tube, something like this, this plastic bottle. But again, I cut the bottom off with a pair of scissors earlier to give me that wide, flat bottom. And then you stick it right in the middle of your saran wrap like so. Fold up the corners very carefully. You don't want to pull too tight or you'll cut with the plastic your saran wrap. I'll show you guys how that looks. You can see straight through it. Even through the camera, you can see straight through the bottom of it. Make sure it sticks nice and snug, but not too tight. Remember, don't cut it with the bottom of your plastic. Then I have some duct tape, which I use to help reinforce the saran wrap. You can use rubber bands or something else that's waterproof. Just make sure your tape is resistant to water so that when you get this wet, you won't end up losing your aquascope. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that now. That's a satisfying sound. I'm just gonna put it along the edges where I see saran wrap. If you wanted, you could go to the dollar store or to Walmart and pick up some different color duct tape. If you're wanting to use duct tape, that way you can add some color to your aquascope to kind of personalize it and make it yours. If you're going to use the rubber bands, then you can do the same. Buy some red, blue, green rubber bands to help reinforce the plastic wrap that you're putting on the aquascope. And that just adds some flavor, some personality, which is always good with science. I'm just gonna go with one more strip. It doesn't have to be the most secure. We just wanna make sure that it's waterproof down here so no water leaks in through the bottom. There you go. It's not the prettiest thing, but it certainly works. So you could take your eye and put it in the top hole here, submerge this into water, and you can see plainly what's underneath. This is, of course, a very basic aquascope that just kind of uses plastic and what we can find around at the house. But Sarah Mather, when she invented her aquascope, had a bunch of different gadgets and gizmos that she incorporated to make her very sophisticated aquascope. And I'm going to let Cartoon Kyle tell you a little bit more about Sarah Mather and the invention of the aquascope.
Sarah Mather lived in Brooklyn, New York in the middle 1850s. Not much is known about her personal life, if she was married or had children, but we can assume that she was rather familiar with boats. She likely knew people around town that worked at nearby ports and heard the foghorns of ships as they docked. She learned the struggles of everyday naval life by living close to the water. It would make sense, with this being her everyday life experience, that she put her mind to work to make the lives of naval workers a little easier. She was granted a patent in April of 1845 for an apparatus of examining objects under the surface of the water, a submarine telescope. In the patent, she specified that her device would not only have a waterproof tube with a lens, but also a lamp built in that would allow those who use it to illuminate the murky depths. She also mentioned that her invention would be useful for examining the bottom of ships without having to raise them out of the water. One only needs to look as far as submarines to see that her simple fixes and improvements have stood the test of time. So you've built your aquascope and now you need to know what to do with it. Well, I had two main ideas. The first is a treasure hunting challenge. Start by filling a large bucket, bowl, sink, or tub with warm water. Then add dish soap to the water so it's nice and sudsy and you have plenty of bubbles that cover the top. Fill a bag with all sorts of waterproof treasures like toys or coins and drop them into the warm water covered in suds. Once you're ready, start a timer and see how fast you can find all of the hidden treasures beneath the surface of the water. Then stop the clock. Then time yourself again, only this time use your aquascope to look beneath the suds of the water. See if it helps you speed up your time. The second thing is for you to go and explore the ocean blue. Rivers and ponds work too. Take your aquascope to a body of water and use it to look beneath the surface. It's even better if it's a sunny day or the water is a little disturbed. The glare from the sun or debris in the water will help prove how useful the aquascope can be. Turn your looking into a scavenger hunt. I'll actually link one that I made myself in the description below. Try to identify animals, plants, and rocks or soil. This is an amazing way to learn about our world, especially the one right in our backyard. Thank you guys for watching this video, and I hope you learned a little something about Sarah Mather. It's really cool to learn about female scientists and inventors, especially during Women's History Month. Be sure to like this video if you liked it, sub if you loved it, and be sure to let us know on Facebook if you found anything interesting during your scavenger hunt. Stay safe, wash your hands, and we'll see you in the next one. Bye.